Celeste is all about overcoming challenges. It eases you into new obstacles every chapter, and teaches you new mechanics even after hours of gameplay. Then everything you've learned culminates into challenging gameplay that you never expected you'd be capable of. Even beyond the casual experience, almost every player I know has accomplished significantly more than they thought they could. But what Celeste doesn't prepare you for is the impossible. It's easy to put people or certain accomplishments on an unreachable pedestal. For me, that was sub 30 any%. When I started playing the game actively around the end of 2020, I watched progress tutorials and I got a mid 40 any%. I distinctly remember thinking, sub 30 is impossible. It's hard to comprehend how I would even do that, so I thought, I guess they're just better at the game than me. Well, in July 2021, I got my first sub 30 any%. It's incredible to see your name among the people you looked up to and learned from. It helps you realize that the way you define unreachable goals is mostly a mental battle. So nothing's impossible, right? A common sentiment shared by the community was how good the 202 world record was. When it happened Christmas of 2019, it was absolutely an incredible run. People were saying it was unbeatable and the category was dead. So of course, in June 2022, I set my sights on beating it. I split up 202 into three segments, 100% Feral Golden and 25 Goldens. I started working on 25 Goldens and the time to beat was 1:22:54. I did some partial runs as I was choosing and learning strats to get an idea of how they felt in full game. At this point, I was also recording my strats into a reference playlist since I knew this would take a while. After selecting all of my strats and refining them, in mid-July, I got a 2-segment run during practice. This beat the world record at the time, but I was still slower than the goal of 1:1x. By the end of August, after strat iterations and consistency practice, I hit my goal time with a 1:17:09, 25 Goldens world record, and my first successful Feral Golden run with preliminary strats. I was on track to beating this. Now the only thing left was to learn strats for a mid-140 100%. I learned some comfy full clear strats, and in Summit full clear, I actually ended up tying second place. Then on September 9th, 2022, I got carried away grinding Shaft full clear Consob and encountered hand issues. Hand strain isn't something I wasn't already familiar with. Many of my previous runs had commented on minor issues, but I would take breaks to play sustainably. But this time, it was different. I had to take an extended break from anything too straining, and for a while, I thought I would never be able to play Celeste again. I slowly eased back in with more sustainable habits, continued learning 100% spread out across a long time. Early 2023, I decided to start recording my strats into task files. This meant I could record my strat execution and be able to play them back with notes on strat details or cues written in line. A big benefit of this is being able to de-rust without physically playing, while also being flexible enough to update strat changes without re-recording a whole reference video. With a more ergonomic keyboard, better keybinds, better habits, and a way to refresh my memory without physical exertion, I was set up to start preparing for a fall 202 run. On and off practicing throughout the year brings us to September 2023. I was nowhere close to where I wanted to be consistency-wise, but with the anniversary of Farewell coming up, I decided I would try a full 202 run for fun. The run started off pretty well, getting a PB in the 100% portion. Now this is where the run gets very punishing. Dying in Celeste typically only loses seconds, but dying in Golden speedruns can lose time in the magnitude of minutes, depending on how deep you were in the chapter. That's why my approach for spearing Goldens is comfy strats I'm confident. Okay. So I'm 1 hour 50 minutes into my run, and I just lost 4.5 minutes to letting go of up too quickly. Unfortunate, but my gold time has some buffer to account for golden deaths, so it should be fine as long as I don't need big deaths like this. Uh-oh. Somehow I managed to save that, and got second attempt Feral Golden.
Nice.
With the hardest golden out of the way, I needed something easy to do, so I chose 8A Golden. This ended up being a terrible choice. I had 2 frustrating deaths, 1 to a memory issue, and 1 to just being a silly goose. I left to do some other Goldens, came back, had another silly moment, and got it with a total of 6 minutes lost across 3 deaths. This combined with two very big deaths and 7B for a combined 9 minutes, it was feeling pretty doomed. I basically just played it out at this point for practice, not expecting too much. After all, this was my first run for fun. The rest of the run went surprisingly well, even messing around a bit at some points. But then, as I finished the Ray Golden and looked at the journal, the pace was looking interesting. I did some rough calculations with the length of the remaining chapters. It was looking winnable. At this point, I went completely silent to focus. I played well for these remaining chapters and even started greeting my menuing. Now, the only things left were 1A Golden and 1A Dashless. And I did them at the same time. I knew I needed a clean double golden run to beat the world record. Any mistake at this point would kill the run.
Nice. I win. Anyone can cook?
After over a year of learning, practicing, and mostly resting my hands, I was able to get the 202 world record. I overcame the impossible. I yapped for quite some time after my run, so here's a TLDR of the speech. I thought accomplishments like 202 and even sub 30% were things you could only do if you were just inherently good at the game. Well, I've gotten sub 30 and now 202 world record. Me from 2020 was so clueless. Nobody is inherently better. It's just a matter of how much you're willing to learn and improve. Play what you enjoy and go for whatever accomplishment you value. But don't limit yourself because you don't think you can. I strongly believe that anyone can do anything. Anyone can cook. My 202 run was far from perfect and is nowhere close to my most optimized run, but it's the run I'm most proud of. And that's because this run had something no other PB had. A message.